Hello, folks! My name is Rojo, and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. When we last left off, we were still messing around in the catacombs a little bit, but we learned some things, we beat a boss, and we were sort of talking to some people in Firelink. In particular, I'm wondering where Irina went. She's blind, after all. Let's see, does he have anything to say?
You offed the Lords of Cinder. The Undead Legion. So that's how they're delivered to their thrones. I pity the sorry souls. Is that really Lordship's last reward? I failed to thank you. For helping them find their final resting place.
Gave us the Farron Ring. That's interesting. Very interesting.
I pity the sorry son.
All right, let's take a look at this ring that he gave us. Right about here. We're not going to wear it as a coat. Let's see. Farron Ring. Where are you at? Right here. Reduces skill FP consumption. The Abyss Watchers for their hunting The Abyss Watchers for their hunting required a sword technique that went beyond any existing art. Wolf's Blood provided just that, and this ring further extends the effect. We're not gonna wear that ring. We're not really using too many weapon arts here, so not gonna sweat it. But let's talk to some more people real quick.
Welcome home, speak, Ashen One.
So she doesn't know anything. Maybe she knows something.
Ashen One, bring with.
Is it?
Nothing.
Ashen.
Nothing from her. Maybe Andre knows something. Kind of doubt it.
Tis good, wasn't it? Weapons and they so. Pretty, I don't.
Nobody seems to know anything.
Hand in one. You can keep the ring.
Let's go. Let's go and just double check over here. Maybe there's like something that I missed that's like a clue. It doesn't seem like it. Huh. Well, in that case, I guess we should move on for now, probably. Now, let's see, actually, let's come up here real quick. This guy's here.
Now invade and come on.
Yeah. All right, well, I think it's time to move on. Just taking a look outside here to see if we can see anything. There's somebody down there. Let's have a chat with. Oh, that's Egon, actually. Forgot about these guys, I forgot that they get up. Let's go ahead and deal with this real quick. There we go, easy enough. Fading Soul, sure, we'll take it. Probably don't need to kill those guys.
I made myself very clear.
Whoa!
My allegiance remained only as long as you assured the girl's safety. This Knight of Kareem does not forgive betrayal. Even a broken woman deserves a dignity.
He seems to be pissed. And I think I have an idea as to why. I'm gonna actually, do some deep protection here, I think. Alright, now let's do the thing. Don't want to knock him off the edge, because then we'll have to reload if he drops stuff for us. So, figure this is the best way to do it. I was kind of hoping to get a backstab there, but it didn't pan out. And he's out. He doesn't have any Estus, I guess.
Arena. This bastard.
Oh, man. That's a little bit sad. But I think we should try and talk to Arena before I do any further speculation. Oh, that's her right there.
Who is there? Someone there? Anyone? Oh, sweet champion. Where have you been? Please, your touch. The little creatures, how they nip and bite.
Very strange interaction there. So my thought is that Egon was pissed because we made her tell us some rather dark tales. And he's a Knight of Kareem, and he's sworn to protect her, as we already know. So he was just doing his job, and we had to put him down, basically. That or let him go. He did drop a couple items for us. One would be a big-ass hammer. He's actually not as tough as I would have expected. And also a shield. Where's that shield at? I think it's this one. The Moaning Shield. A deformed great shield given to Egon of Kareem upon being conferred knighthood. The giant woman's face that protects Egon is that of his sister, some years his senior. So we can attract enemies with it. That's interesting. And then the hammer. Great hammer bestowed upon Kareem Knights with demonstrate outstanding strength and unwavering faith. Probably who demonstrate. Decorated by a warding charm of Kareem Temple and imbued with the twisted rage of Apostle Morn. Morn's rage. Well, we're not going to be using this for reasons such as it requires 30 faith and 50 strength. So, you would think that guy would be a lot tougher, but I don't think he ever hit us. So maybe he does a shitload of damage or something. Well, let's go back and just check on Arena to see if she's back. And she is indeed.
Oh, please, the little creature. You know, in my eye with it, how terrible.
Kind of was hoping she'd have something else to say about all that. What do we need for Darkblade? 25 faith? Maybe we'll get 25 faith for Darkblade.
Oh, please.
At some point. But for now, I think our work here is done. Let's actually get back into the action here. Now, I think we're going to go... back to Wolnir. Alright. Let's see what's behind this door that we opened up. I'm curious. Curious indeed. Up and up and up and up and... Oh, look at that. Irithyll of the Boreal Valley. We've heard about the Boreal Valley before. Vort, the first boss. Well, I guess the second boss. The first real boss that we fought. Yeah. He's, presumably from this area. So a really nice looking place, actually. Let's go ahead and light ourselves a bonfire, I think. And let's take a look around to see what we got going on here. Let's see. Anything? Anything good? Doesn't seem like it. I'm going to go ahead and put deep protection on for no particular reason. Go a little bit this way. Oh. Oh, shit. These things are fucking assholes. They're extremely, extremely strong. And very, very, very aggressive. Very aggressive. Don't want to get grabbed by that. If that happens, that's pretty much death with our current HP totals. We can bleed this guy, it looks like. Should have maybe put on some Karthus Rouge as well. Would have been a good idea. But there we go, we got him. Got the Pontiff's right eye. What does the Pontiff's right eye do? Keep going to the wrong screen for that. Pontiff's, see, we have his left eye. Restores HP with successive attacks. We got that as a boss soul item, I think. And then we have the right eye now, which boosts attack as long as attacking persists. Let's see. Knights who appear in a black orb. I think we've already read all this. I think it's exactly the same, yeah. We're going to wear the Pontiff's right eye, I think. I think it's going to be better than the milk ring for us. Just because we can attack so many times. It seems like it'll be good. It was definitely good with the S-Talk, so we'll give it a try, see how it goes. If it doesn't look like it's going to pan out for us, then we'll, you know, we can switch it up. No big deal. Now then, we need to go through here. And we wouldn't be able to do that if we didn't have this doll that we got from the Cathedral of the Deep. So, because I think there's actually a developer message back that way. One more bone, just in case you don't have the doll. But voila. We can go right through, no sweat. Good times. Okay, let's go ahead and light up this bonfire. And we're going to actually try something. I don't know if this is going to work or not. We're going to go back to this bonfire. There's a reason for us to do this. I think, anyway. So we'll see if, it pans out for us here. Ah, gorgeous view. Indeed it is. Now then, I think somewhere around here, we should find something. Right here, maybe. Yeah, so I missed this in my first playthrough, because you have to reload the area for it to show up. But answer Sirius of the Sunless Realms call for cooperation to be summoned as a phantom. Let's do that. This is kind of interesting. It's I guess a unique feature to the Soul series, being able to be summoned by NPCs like this. What is going on here? Oh, wow! It's Creighton from whatever. Oh, she can heal too, that's good. There we go, let's get on the offensive a little bit here. Ooh, ow! but yeah, Creighton is from Dark Souls 2, I think. If I recall. It's gonna keep Estusing up here. There we go, that's the backstab I'm looking for. Hopefully he can't, oh, he can Estus, that's not good. Oh, she's got, Dark Moon Blade on or something. Get another backstab on him. For whatever that's worth. There we go. I'm actually a little bit surprised I haven't been able to get a bleed off on him. Oh, we died. That's okay, we can try it again, I think. Pretty sure. Hopefully, anyway. Let's, yeah, I don't think we lose anything for failing there. But what I will do is... I'm going to put on some Karthus Rouge here, and see, we'll see how it works for us. And maybe we'll do some poison? Try some poison. Let's try some poison. We're not going to use it on much else, so... we'll do this again. I'm not going to worry quite as much about the deep protection this time around, since the action starts pretty hastily. So we'll see if we can make this work for us. I don't think I can buff before I come in here, so... Okay. Buff up a little bit here. You can see we only have, like, half Estus, so... It's less than ideal. That's just a mechanic of... That's just a mechanic of being summoned, really. We also have less HP, as you can see. Here we go. As long as we can... As long as we can keep him busy, I think we're gonna be okay. Didn't get the backstab there. Was feeling like surely I would. There we go, we got the bleed. And he's dead. Good stuff. Never actually poisoned him, though.
Thank you for your kind assistance. Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
Hooray! My arms go through my hat. Are you gonna send... There we go, I was gonna say, are you gonna send me back or what? So that's good. We should maybe try... Going back to Firelink, maybe? Just for a moment here. Just for a moment here. To see if she's in Firelink, for one. And two... to talk to somebody else. Let's see here, so we go to Firelink Shrine. Should only take a second, I think. Yeah, she is here. Good stuff. Let's have a chat.
I have not thanked you for your generous rescue. That dark spirit was one of Rosaria's fingers. Vile, bastard offspring who lurk in the darkness. My sworn enemies. Fearsome invaders, to say the least. I would not have made it alone. You have my deepest gratitude.
Cool. Gave us a blessed mailbreaker and a silver cat ring.
If you require help on your travels, I offer you my sign. Blessing of the moon upon your journey. If you require blessing...
Okay. So, it seems like, she appears to be a Blade of the Dark Moon or something like it. And it appears that perhaps that covenant is, sort of at war with the, with Rosaria's fingers. It's probably a good thing we never officially did anything with that covenant, otherwise she might be rather upset. let's see here. So she gave us a blessed mailbreaker. I think it's just a mailbreaker. Yeah. But blessed means it's good against skeletons, I think. And also it'll slowly heal you if you have it out. So it's an interesting item, but we won't be using it. And then, of course, we also get the Silver Cat Ring, which prevents falling damage. So it's sort of like permanent spook as far as just falling goes. I didn't get this in my last playthrough. Silver Ring depicting a leaping feline prevents damage from falling in the Age of Gods, or possibly just following it. An old cat was said to speak a human tongue, with the voice of an old woman, in the form of a fanciful immortal. So, they're probably talking about Elvina there, I think, from the first Dark Souls, but it could also be, I think, Shao Kuan? I think that was her name? She was a cat in Dark Souls 2 in town, but she didn't really have the voice of an old woman. She sounded younger. So yeah, interesting little bit of lore there. But let's go ahead and... actually, we gotta talk to one more person, I forgot. Come over... This guy's, like, in our shit. Let's come over here, and I want to holler at Grey Rat real quick. Hello, my friend.
Oh, hello.
Fine work, I say. Discovering Irithyll in the Boreal Valley all in a day's work. If the tales are true, it is home to old moon-worshipping nobles and should be packed with treasure. What do you think? Shall I go and see what I can find?
Yes.
A fine choice. I am Grey Rat the Thief. What I bring back will be worthy of that name.
Hope so. Let's stock up on some arrows before he pieces out, though. Let's get some of those. And he doesn't seem to have anything else that we really need right now, so I think we'll just leave him be.
I am Grey Rat. I am...
Whoop. And, okay, let's get out of here. Let's get out of here. Now, I think, actually, I'm going to go on the route that I went in my first playthrough, which means we're actually not going to be going back to Irithyll just yet. We're instead going to be going, let's see, High Lord Wolnir. Actually, no, I guess we could have just gone to the Abandoned Tomb. My mistake. But yeah, we're going to be going down that way instead, I think. We'll see how it goes for us. It could go quite poorly, so... Let's go down here, I think. Not sure if we have enough souls to level up. It's possible that we did, but I'm not gonna sweat it too much. Okay, so now we're gonna come down here. Yes, indeed, down here. To the Smoldering Lake. This place... can suck a dick, honestly, because there is a giant ballista shooting a bunch of bullshit at us the whole time we're here, pretty much. At least the whole time we're down here. Oh! Shoots three at a time. So, gonna have to do our best to avoid it. I think we can... For quick, we can get over here, and we'll be out of sight. Ooh, crystal lizard. Ah, no, don't run from me. Come back. God damn you. I can't catch him. I can't catch him. Oh my God, please. Jesus Christ. Twinkling Titanite, great. Just what I needed. Ooh, there's another crystal lizard. Let's, what have you done, Crystal Lizard? How is this possible? And he died. We got a Titanite chunk, that's our first one. I think anyway, that's pretty good. Let's, be prepared for combat here, I think. Sadness ahead? Yeah, I would say so, probably. That may or may not be true. But who is this that we have here? Who indeed? It's Horus. As in Henri's Horus. Why is Horus here? This is a good question. This is a good question indeed. There we go, we got the poison on him. Not sure if he has any Estus or not, but his shield isn't very big, so he can just bust right through it. And he should die. Good stuff. Sorry, Horus. Why did he attack us? I don't know. I really have no idea. Yuria did say somebody was leading her on the right path, but this doesn't seem like he was leading her anywhere. He seems like he just kind of peaced out. Let's take a look at the shield that he gave us, though. Metal shield crafted by the Great Smith. Fashioned from rare gay steel, it excels at various types of damage absorption. And it has parry on it. Is it, like, a good parry? No. No, it is not. But, still, it's, you know, it's something alright. The gay steel thing, or guy steel, I guess maybe, it's from Dark Souls 2. if I recall. I'm also realizing we should probably wear this shield. For some reason, I was thinking we didn't get it yet, but we totally did. We just need two more points of strength to actually put it on, because then we can parry and we still have 100% physical block when we need it. I'll have to think about that. For now, Titanite Shard. And phone's ringing. Apologies, one second. Alright, let's see. What is... I would like to pillage, please. Yellow bug pellets. We'll, find a use for those before too long, I'm sure. And here, another large Titanite shard. So large Titanite is good. We're going to start seeing a lot of that, I think. But, for now, I think that's all we got here. What does it say? Tears? Yeah, I suppose. I suppose. Okay. Moving on. We can probably ditch this resin now. And get back out of this cave. Now I'm thinking, we need to go sort of in the other direction. To the... Why do I hear... No, I guess that's just a ballista. Okay. Oh, and he can see me from there. All right, that's fine. Just have to try to be quick. Where is he at? It's over there. I'm gonna grab some treasure here. I'm gonna try anyway. Where is he? Ah, there he is, okay. There we go. And, of course, we have this giant asshole worm here now. I think if we keep running, we'll be okay. Oh, guess not, actually. We want to try to get past this worm, if at all possible. And it should be. Should be possible. There we go. It's gonna... go under for a second. And we are going to run right by him. There's some treasure that we can pick up underneath him or whatever, but we don't really need to worry about that right now. There's also a boss fog here. But we're actually more interested in this very second in grabbing that and coming down here instead. We require... this bonfire, because it's way better than running from the other bonfire. Alright, let's see. Any summons here? Night Slayer Sorg. Oh, yeah, we killed him. Guess he's on our team now. I'm not sure what all good he's gonna do us. Maybe he's got another gesture for us. Oh. Turn around a little bit. I wonder if we can, let's see. Where is it? There we go. He doesn't seem to be interested. Alright, well let's unsummon him real quick. Thanks, but no thanks, Sorg. What about up here? There was another summon sign, I thought. Maybe that one was a player, though. Wonder if there's anybody over here. Actually, I need to be a little bit more cautious here. Yeah, come over here. We're going to put on some Karthus Rouge. We're going to give this boss one try this episode. If we don't make it, that's okay. That's okay. Yeah, I don't see any other summons, so... let's go ahead and get in here. Alright, deep protection. Karthus Rouge. I think this boss is supposed to be weak to bleed. We'll see if that's true or not. I'm gonna actually get right up in his shit here. This is the old Demon King. Certainly looks like a demon. Certainly looks like a demon. Ow. Probably could have done with, like, a red bug pellet or something, too. We actually staggered him there a little bit, it looks like. He is pissed now. Doesn't seem like he's bleeding, though. This is a good opportunity to hit him. Oh, we actually staggered him out of the attack there. That's not something that I expected to see. Ah, no. That's bad. Didn't mean to re-carth this rouge there. Did not mean to do that. That attack is very difficult to dodge at close range, as you can imagine. Roll through that, or try to roll through that and fail, I guess. That's fine. Stay away from the fire. Just gonna do some fire breath. I'm gonna try and get around him here. There we go. It's best if you just stick right up in the shit with him here. There we go. Ooh, ow. Let's not get hit by the combustion here. Just gonna do one of those. It's okay. Another one of those. There we go. Think we might get him here. Oh, ow. That did not feel very good. Oh, he's down. And now he's dead. Took me a few tries to kill this guy in my other playthrough, but these swords are doing work. So the old Demon King. We'll check that out next episode, but until then, we shall actually light this bonfire, I guess. May as well rest at it. Now we definitely have some souls to spend, so we'll probably do that next episode too. But until next time, my name has been Rojo, and thanks for watching.